Hello, and thank you so much for joining me here on my channel. I'm going to be doing the Capricorn Daily Energy Reading. As always, take what resonates, leave what does not, especially since this is a general reading. All right. Okay, so we have the Two of Swords, we have the Wheel, and we have the Ten of Wands. So what you may be struggling with. I feel that you have a heavy burden on your back. I feel like you have a lot of weight on your shoulders. I feel like you have a lot of responsibility. I also feel like you're wanting some change, but you're not really sure what that change is or what it should be or if you should even pursue it. For some reason, I feel like you're used to having all of these Ten of Wands on your back. I feel like you're used to carrying the load, like you're used to always having this responsibility or, and that's definitely the way Capricorn is. I'm a Capricorn sun and a Capricorn rising, is that we feel that we need to take on the responsibility for things and carry the load for other people, especially if it's people that we care about. Like, we want to do everything that we can to help that person. But we also have to realize is that it puts a heavy burden on yourself. It puts a heavy burden on you, and it kind of holds you back from pursuing things. I feel that you're kind of at this, you're kind of thinking about it, like you're thinking about it, like you're not really clear because we have the Moon here. I feel like you're not really clear, you're not really to the point where you're ready to make some changes, but I feel like you have this change that you feel that you want to have happen, because I feel that you're kind of at the end, like you feel like, I just feel like you're ready to focus on you. I feel like you've helped this other person, or you've carried this load, this Ten of Wands, whatever that may be, is you've carried this for a while, but I almost feel, I heard, was it, I think it was Minnow Pond. I'd watched one of his videos yesterday, and he said that like he was feeling that Capricorns are going through transformation, and that's what I've been feeling too, and definitely what I've been going through, is that Capricorns have been carrying this Ten of Wands for a while now, and Capricorns are ready to start setting themselves free and to start focusing on themselves and focusing and making choices that are really, that are really helping them to bring changes in, and that it's okay to focus on you. That when, again, like when you put the oxygen mask on yourself, then you're able to help other people. It's not to say that you're not gonna help this other person, but I feel like Capricorns are ready to focus on them, and they're ready for all of this hard work that they've been putting in. And they're ready for those rewards. They're ready for that transformation. They're ready for those changes. But we're all obviously, you know, going at our own pace. And some of us have already gone through those changes, and some of us are still working on those. And I feel like you're kind of at that cusp of where you're ready to switch over. Like you're ready, like it's definitely on your mind. It's definitely something that you're thinking about, of releasing this burden that you have on yourself, whatever this Ten of Wands may represent for you. Like you're ready to end it, because tens can be completions. And I feel like you're ready to end it, but you're not quite there. Let's look at some advice from the tarot for Capricorn in this situation where they are carrying this heavy burden. So what advice do you have for Capricorn? Why am I not surprised? But it does make sense though. Okay, I love it. So we have the Tower, we have the Queen of Pentacles, and we have the Ten of Cups. So I love that. I love that, the advice from the tarot. As I've said many times before, is that I like the Tower because the Tower represents change, right? It's kind of like the Wheel. It represents change. It also represents getting rid of that falsehood that maybe you've been telling yourself that you have to carry this burden, that you have to have this Ten of Wands. And it's time for you to say, you know what, I don't have to do that. That I can switch that from the Ten of Wands to this Ten of Cups, right? That I can change that, that I can turn that around. We have the Queen of Pentacles, which can represent you. And I feel like, I always feel like the Queen of Pentacles is somebody who is very grounded. And I also feel like she is someone who is, who I just feel like it's being your own best friend and looking out for yourself. And I feel like it's focusing on your pursuits, focusing on what it is that makes you happy and kind of looking within, because she's kind of looking down there. And I feel like it's, and it's almost like she's staring at that pentacle and saying, you know, I really have this opportunity, or I really want to bring in these changes, and I really need to stay strong. I really need to push through this situation. It's that tower, creating that tower. And when we go through that tower, yes, it feels really scary, and it can feel, because it represents change. I feel like it's time for you to change things. With the advice from the tarot, is with the tower coming in, it's like it's time to tear things down. It's time to dispel those false beliefs that you may have, or those burdens that you have been putting on your back, and it's time to change those. It's time to let that go. And in doing that, I feel like it's definitely going, having a shift, and there may be this time of where you feel like you're not really in control, or you're not really sure. But I feel like it's helping you to grow into this Ten of Cups. Like, it's time for you to have your Ten of Cups. It's time for you to have this feeling of fulfillment and stability and safeness and happiness and joy, and to not always feel like you have all this weight on your shoulders, and that it's, you know, it's like the head is down here, but the head is up here saying, yes, like, thank you. You know what I mean? It's time for you to have that. And you have to be in that frame of mind to be able to receive that. That if you're still in this Ten of Wands energy and in the self-doubt, then you're not going to be able to fully embrace this Ten of Cups that, and the tower that wants to come in. But the advice from the tarot is saying, yeah, like, tear that down. Have that tower moment. Create that tower moment. Do what it is that you need to do in order to bring in this Ten of Cups, whatever that may be. Let's see what is coming in for Capricorn. Queen of Wands. I love the Queen of Wands. That's what I was feeling like, Ace of Pentacles. When I saw this pentacle here, and like, I, for some reason I thought the Ace of Pentacles was already here, and I love that it just came out here. So we have the Queen of Wands, we have the Ace of Pentacles. All right. We have the Devil card, and then we have the Hermit card. So there are some major cards. So this is the energy that wants to come in here for you, okay? I love the Queen of Wands because she's fiery, she's feisty, she makes things happen, she doesn't put up with stuff, she's determined. I do feel that the Queen of Pentacles has those same qualities, but it's kind of at a, I feel like it's kind of like at a softer level. But I feel like the Queen of Wands is just somebody who's in your face. And I, even though that's not Capricorn, but it's almost like when you have to pursue your dreams and you have to go after your things, then Capricorn can be in your face, right? If you rile one up, right? Like, you don't really want to rile one up, but if you do, like, that person's going to be in your face. And I feel like that's kind of you, is embracing that in your face energy. And that's what wants to come in for you, to empower you and to take those actions, right? Wands are actions. Take those actions to make things happen. And I feel like it has something to do with money. I feel like it has to do with business or career. And I feel like it's almost like she's looking right at that, like, the opportunity is there. I'm looking at that hand. It's like the Queen of Wands is looking right at that pentacle, and that hand is out there, and it's like that opportunity is coming here for you. And it's, see it with both eyes, see that opportunity and follow it through. Don't let negativity hold you back with this Devil card, but I also feel like it's empower yourself, right, to get into your strength and your power. And then we have the Hermit card, which is looking within, looking within to really dig deep and find. It's like, and then it's like the Hermit is shining the light on the Devil card. And I also feel like it's looking at those toxic energy or those negativities or those things that are holding you back. Like, I feel like the light is being shined right on this right here, that chain that is holding you down. Shine the light on that and see what that is so that you can break those chains, right? That you can look at those things that hold you back, right? That have put you in this energy of this Ten of Wands where you feel you have to take on the burden and responsibility for all of these other things or to put that on yourself. And that maybe that's your comfort zone, is this Ten of Wands where you feel you have the burdens, all of these burdens that you have to deal with. And maybe that's your comfort zone. And so you constantly do things to put more things on your back, to put more wands, right, on you that you have to deal with. And maybe that's what, like, you've been dealing with, but now it's time to break that, right, with the Tower. Now it's time to change that. Now it's time to have a lighter load right here with this Ten of Cups, right? Something that is lighter, something that brings in that positive energy, and start pursuing those things that make you happy. And I feel like it's seeing those things within yourself that hold you back or that keep you in this negativity. And I feel like that's what I've felt for a while, that that's what Capricorn has been going through. That Capricorn has been going through that transformation and change over the years, and that they're really looking out for themselves, and they're really kind of exposing those things where that negativity that they have, and that they're bringing that to the light, and they're seeing that, and they're changing that. And I feel like that's an amazing thing. Like, that's a really good feeling. That's definitely what I've been going through, is kind of seeing those negative things that I've been doing and changing those, right, and doing those differently, because I'm tired of always having this Ten of Wands on my back. I'm ready for change. You have to be in the frame of mind to be able to see these things and realize them and to change those things. I just had a breakthrough the other day, yesterday. There was a video that I was watching, like, it has to do with money, and so I had a major, like, breakthrough with that, about how I feel about money, and that it just all made sense. And I feel like that's one I've been dealing with for like the last 2 weeks, but yesterday was definitely another breakthrough. So it's like kind of seeing those things and realizing how I feel about those things and the negative things that I feel towards that, right? And to turn that around and to change that. But it's like we all have those different things that create those wands that we have in our back. And that, you know, I'm still going through changes. I've definitely come a long way and I'm super proud of myself, but it's like I still have more changes to go and more towers. But I embrace those because I love having those moments where I realize, oh, I was thinking this negative way, this Devil card way, but I need to think this Ten of Cups way, that I need to turn that around. I need to change that. Because when I do that, life just seems so much lighter and it just releases a lot of stress and anxiety. Let's look at some advice from the animal oracle. Little steps, baby steps, mouse spirit, tend to the small things. And I feel like it's those baby steps. It doesn't mean everything has to be done at once. Sometimes I feel that we have to supersize it, right? Or Big Mac it. I haven't had a Big Mac in forever. I love Big Macs. That's always, when I went to McDonald's, I would always have a Big Mac. Those are so good. A Big Mac or a cheeseburger. Those are my two. But tending to the small things, it's like realizing that it's those little steps that matter. It's those little things that we change. It's those little things that we catch, that negativity that we catch, those falling back into old ways or old habits that we catch. It's the little baby steps, right? Sometimes we want to take giant steps and that's just too much. It's like appreciating and being grateful for those little steps that we take, those little things that we notice, those little things that we pick up on, those little things that we do, right? So it's the advice from the animal oracle is to take those baby steps, and those are okay. Like, it's okay to take the baby steps. Let's grab a card from advice from the Star Dragons for you. For some reason, those are, I think the whole deck is upside down. Okay. We have the self, gathering your power. Exactly. That's exactly what I feel this reading is gathering your power and working on yourself. Definitely with this tower moment here is gathering your power. There's a sense of loss of power with this Ten of Wands by carrying this burden. And there's a sense of power with this Ten of Cups where you're freeing yourself, right? And you're releasing that load. And you're, you know, maybe it's with this 10 to the small things, the little steps is maybe it's like getting rid of one wand, right? And bringing that down to 9 wands and then bringing that down to 8 wands and then bringing it down to 7, right? And then maybe it's 5. So it's like, maybe that's what it is. It's like, you don't have to make these big changes right away, but it's making those little changes and kind of releasing that each time. And each time you feel that release that you're like, oh, I want even more of this, right? That I want to feel, I want to release even more of these wands that I have on my back. Let's grab some advice from the Whispers of Healing here for Capricorn. We have unexpected. I love it. You never know what could happen, right? What's around each corner, what's going to happen each day or in each moment, or each little step forward that you take, you never know what could happen. And that it could be this beautiful castle, right? Right around the corner. It could be this feeling that you didn't even know could exist, this way of being that you didn't even know could exist because you had all of these wands on top of you that you only kind of saw things from one, right? When you're looking down, you're only seeing what is right in front of you. You're only seeing in this area here. But when you're looking up, you're seeing like up above here and you're seeing all around you. Of course, you can't see behind you. But I mean, it's like you're really broadening your horizons and you're seeing a lot more things. And I feel like that's kind of like what's going on here is that when you're looking up and you're looking around and you don't have these burdens where you're just focused maybe on the negative and like, I have to carry this burden, and you're able to slowly release those and move your head up and look around, then you're able to see different things and you're able to see different opportunities and have a different perspective. And I feel like it's things that you couldn't even imagine over here because you were only looking in this small area, that when you make these changes that you see these new things that you couldn't even imagine over here because it wasn't even in your peripheral view. It wasn't even in your view, if that makes sense. All right, let's grab a psychic tarot. I love it. Six of Pentacles, material and spiritual prosperity. That's what wants to come in for you without a doubt. I feel like that's what this reading is you have this Ace of Pentacles here. So I feel like this represents the material prosperity, but the spiritual prosperity I feel represents this Ten of Cups, right? And this tower is what, when you're in a good frame of mind, when you're really feeling good about yourself, then it's like you help yourself in different areas of your life. Like you choose better friendships, you make better choices. So yesterday morning, I was having a really rough time. And I don't know if I'd already said this in another video, but when I was having a rough time, I like to have potato chips. I had went to Walmart and I was like, oh, I want a bag of potato chips. So I came home and I ate some of the potato chips. And then I was like, you know what? This is the old me. Like, this is what I would have used to have done, is get myself into a junk food phase and then feel really miserable about myself. And when I eat junk food, it makes me feel very heavy. And I was like, I don't want to feel like this. And so I had put the bag, I was like deciding, I was like, do I throw the rest of them away or not? So I had put the bag in the cabinet, and then I started to get ready to make some videos, and I thought about it, and I'm like, you know what? And I wasn't feeling good, and my stomach was kind of bothering me, and I was feeling heavy and lethargic, and I was like, you know what? I'm going to throw those chips away. So I went, I took them out of the cabinet, and I threw them in the garbage, and I was so proud of myself. I was like, and even today, I woke up this morning and I was like, you know what? I'm so proud of myself for throwing those away, because that was the old me. That was what I would have done before. And I was really able to turn, I was so proud of myself for being able to turn myself around yesterday, even though I was struggling. And I feel like it's those, again, those little steps, those small steps, even though it was really small that I just threw the bag of potato chips away, but I was still able to recognize what those represented to me and what I was going to feel like and what I was choosing to avoid and to not fall back into that old pattern, right? It was just something that I realized. And I feel like it's that spiritual prosperity within yourself, knowing that, hey, I don't want to do that to myself, because again, being in that best friend energy of that Queen of Pentacles and saying, you know what, I don't want to do that to myself. I don't want to put myself in that energy of feeling lethargic or feeling bad about myself, or then my clothes become tight. And then usually when I start doing that, then I start buying it again and again and again until I don't want to do it anymore. And I'm able to break that cycle. But I was able to break that cycle within a few hours, and I love that. So let's grab a mending. Okay, love it. Mending yourself. And I feel like what I did yesterday with a potato chip bag was mending myself and helping myself out. Again, being in that Queen of Pentacles energy and saying, you know what, I'm really looking out for myself and saying, but it's a choice that I chose to make within myself. It wasn't something that someone told me. That it was within myself, and it was mending myself and realizing those bad habits that I have that need to be changed, because the outcome was amazing. And again, I feel like it goes with that unexpected, is that I kind of turned the corner there, and the outcome felt so much lighter. I feel like this unexpected doesn't necessarily have to represent something materialistic. It can just be that unexpected feeling that you have, that, you know, those things that you do for yourself that really bring you that sense of contentment or enjoyment or success within yourself. Just those actions that you take, right? That could have been a tower moment for me with the potato chips, was like tearing that down and that false belief that the potato chips were going to make me feel better. Yeah, they kind of did for those few minutes while I ate them, but then afterwards, like the long-term effects of it were not so good. All right, so let's grab a crystal card for you. That one just popped out. I like that. That's pretty colors. We have Big Spite. So we have this crystal right here. Timing, action, and change, right? So that's exactly what I was just talking about, is the timing of it, the action that I took, and the change that I brought in. Timing is everything. And with this crystal, that couldn't be truer. This crystal has an impeccable knack for the right timing and can encourage you to try new things, pursue an opportunity, or change anything that needs an update. This crystal opens a connection between your base chakra and your heart chakra and infuses you with the unconditional love for yourself and others. And I feel like definitely this is what I had, unconditional love for myself, to say that this is not something that you want to do and to choose to throw those out. It encourages energy expressed as action, movement, and progression to move toward true alignment between you and your soul. Update what is outdated with joy and recharge your life. And I feel like this goes back to the Queen of Wands that I was feeling when it said, encourages energy expressed as action, movement, and progression towards true alignment. And I feel like that could also represent this Queen of Wands for that energy that wants to come in for you, is to taking those actions that really bring you into that true alignment of who you really are or who you really want to be, right? I was watching some videos where it was saying to kind of, I think quite a few people have said this, is that, and I think even Alex said that, is that your future self, right? What that person looks like. What advice would that future self tell to your current self? So my future self yesterday was saying, you really don't want to eat those potato chips because they're going to give you temporary fulfillment, but it's going to have long-lasting effects on yourself. And that's not something my future self would be doing, is eating a bag of potato chips when I feel upset. And I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with that. I'm just saying that for me in my life and my choices and who that future self is for me, that person is saying to not do that. And so I feel like that's kind of what's going on here with this crystal, is kind of like having that future self that says, what are those actions What are those actions that you need to take to reach that future self? Again, with that unexpected, I feel like that could goes back to that future self. All right. Thank you so much for watching, especially if you're still hanging in there with me. I greatly appreciate it. I hope you have an amazing day. As always, stay positive, stay safe, and I wish you the best on your journey.